Well, good morning, guys. I was working on this center cowl piece here yesterday. I put a piece of cardboard in the middle of it, spread some Bondo on it, and then I was able to knock it down with my little Bondo plane. I've got this side here fairly clean, and this side is same shape basically. So what I'm going to do today, I'm going to try to get this whole front of this cowl and maybe the rest of this hood, I'm going to get it all down and bondoed up and ready for paint. I watched my videos yesterday and they were kind of boring, so I'm gonna try to set you up on tripod so you get a long view, and then I'm gonna use this little camera here and get you some close-up of how the Bondo and stuff is going on. So maybe it'll be a little more interesting for you. So we'll get set up and press on here. Well, I'm going to do a little A-B test here. On. And recording. We've got some regular straight Bondo here. Put a little bit of hardener in it, probably not enough, about 3/4 of an inch. And I've got a pretty good gap here to fill. This is way too much Bondo. But I'm mixing this up real smooth here. Don't have any lumps in it. I didn't use any body honey. This is mixed good. I've got quite a bit of gap right in this area. And I'm using a lot of pressure on the spreader to get this Bondo into all the holes. I don't have any air gaps. Once I've got it pressured in there, now I'm using a little bit easier stroke here. And I'm trying to get it smooth all the way across, save myself some sanding. Quite a bit back in here that needs to be filled, and I'm putting more Bondo on here than I need. I know for sure. I'm trying to get this done in this one shot. I can still see there's a lot of low right here. Good smooth fill. Left right here in the corner, I want to make sure I get it. Alright, now this bundle's pretty rough at this point, and I quote on it, but I don't want to try to be making it perfect at this point, because I'll just wind up digging a hole in it and I'll have to put more Bondo. It's better to leave it high. Got about this much left. I'll put it on at this corner right here. I can tell it needs a little. Holes. Don't really see any other spots. Get this off of my spatula as good as I can. Bondo rag here finally, and clean this up. So what I'm going to try to do with this time is I've got A, B roll, A camera and B camera. I'm going to try to use a video import feature and sync these things up according to time. And I'll cut back and forth between the two cameras so you can shut this one off. So you can get the overall view, and then I'll try to cut in a close-up of what I did here. Yeah, that's driving real slow. Next thing I'll do, I know I can see that I have a lot of high spots in here, so I'm going to take my little plane. This is still pretty wet. And just kind of take off my obvious highs. And then I'll mix up a thin coat of Bondo and put on here. And that should smooth this out. Anyway, I'll shut you off here. Alright, that should be dry enough for the little body plane to work. It's just a little sticky on the hand. I feel it's a little bit warm. I'm just going to take this gently across here. Just start to see the edge of that cardboard right there, so it'll be pretty easy for me to cut this line and break these two pieces of Bondo. I've got a little low spot right here in the corner, and a pretty good low spot right here, and these corners need a little cleaning. So what I'm going to do is clean this area up with a piece of sandpaper first, and then I'll put another coat of Bondo on here. All right, I've got some hardener mixed up, or Bondo mixed up here with hardener, and kind of runny. I've got a good spatula. Mix this up real good here. And this should should fill this up with a, should be the last time. Might hurt on me before I finish, but again, I'm just using a lot of pressure on it, getting it into little scratches. Pressing it into where my crack is yet. I am trying to fill up these corners here. Avoid that crack for now. Just get this stuff spread on. Sure, I got any little spots being filled. Got a pretty good chunk right here in the corner I need to fix. Put extra lock in this area. As I can see, it's low. Smooth it out a little, feather it up into this top part here, make sure I get all of my corners and cracks that I want to. Got a little right here in this corner. This is good, the bottom is still wet. Good. I have a level I need right here. I'll take some off the top. Try to fill this little corner. Yeah, that's good. The main thing here is I'm getting plenty of bondo on it, so I don't have to come back and do it again. There might be something right in this area. The bondo's starting to stiffen up. So it looks pretty bad right now, but like I say, you don't want to stiffen. You're just wasting your time if you try to smooth something out. It won't smooth out, it'll just dig more holes in it. And I didn't waste very much bondo here. Clean this off with a rag. Cameras, yeah, I got plenty on there. And we'll see what this looks like. Well, now I've hit this with a bondo plane. And it's still not real hard. I'll go ahead and get my board sander on it. Get it all. Looks good. be fairly straight across here, but it's going up. It's like an inch and a quarter wide here, and like an inch here. And it's really giving me kind of a funky look. So I'm gonna use this little tool here and just try to clean up these edges. So now I'll get in there with some hand sandpaper and clean it up. Well, I've got this bottom line real straight. Let's see how the zoom on this works. This bottom line is real straight right here. This one's still going up, so I'm taking my X-Acto knife here. I'm just cutting a parallel line best I can. All right, I need a straight line that is parallel. Yeah, that looks real good. Kind of end my metal a little. Try to clean this area up here. That looks pretty good. This top radius up. I'm using my little board for that. Here in the corner of the radius. Kind of put that curve back in it. I is good. Put this top radius in. Screw it a little. Boring watching this. It's even more boring doing it. Alright, I've got this section right here pretty straight. There's a lot of fill here in the bottom of my curve that I don't want. Big radius fill, so I need to hand sand that out. This bottom part right here now is pretty good where I cut it out with the grinder. I'll put a little radius on that, a little right here on the end. Not perfect, but I may not be able to get much on it because of that plate that's welded in there. I don't think I'm hitting it yet. Just trying to knock that corner off. In this, right in this small area, and luckily it's a little high. So this is a good batch in here vertically. Right here in the bottom particularly. Needs to come down just a little. So probably best way to do that is take some Bondo, put it in with my finger. That'll give me a kind of a soft round spot. So I'm going to go ahead and try to trim this whole thing to where it's parallel. Because right now it's skinny and big, skinny and big. And I'll get this a little closer and then we'll do some fine Bondo work. Well, I got this trimmed down. I'm into my metal here in a couple places. Can't get it any smaller. I actually had done the metal wrong. I can put some Bondo in here and straighten the bottom. The top I can still do something to. but I can't do anything with this corner right here or right here. So what I'm going to do is just take my floppy disk and try to cut that welded plate off there on a corner so I can fill that with Bondo and get it smaller. Up to try to get a radius in it. So I've got it ground down pretty good. I think I'll be good enough to for a rat rod. We'll see. Well, I taped this, put a straight line across here first, so I can continue this, and I welded this curve. It's starting to curve from right here, so I think if I try to make this straight all the way up to here, and then put my curve in it, I'll have some success. I've got some Bondo here. It's not been thinned. I think it got too much thinner in it. I mean, hardener. So I'm gonna just try to get this mixed up as fast as I can. And just fill this whole section here where I need it. Have a lot of pinholes or anything, so that'll be pretty good to go. And I'm kind of getting it down here onto this bottom tape because I know I'm going to need it. And then I'll just sort of put a radius in it here with the edge of the spreader. Good enough. I'll just try to use it all up before it gets hard. I got something here I mixed way too much. Got a little piece of dirt. Section right here still rough. And I've got a few scrapes in here. Yeah, that's cleaning this up pretty good. And I forgot I've got a lot to do down here on this bottom section of the cowl. It can take some fill. Looks like I was able to get my Bondo on pretty good before it hardened. I'll still take a little off of here. Putting it in this little screw hole. City Bondo. Need to fill this whole thing here in the bottom. Well, I'm sitting here looking at it and looks pretty good as far as parallel goes. Got a little bit of a wide spot right here. But you really won't notice that, I don't think. Probably nobody will notice it. They'll be so busy looking at everything else, they won't really notice a little body line. But that's the purpose, so that you don't see the body line. You know, you don't want to have something crooked on the car right next to something pretty, because it'll just drag your eye to it. So anyway, I've got Bondo on this. I'll let it cure up a little bit, and I can trim it with a piece of sandpaper while it's not real hard. And I think we should be good to finish that up with glazing putty. Well, I knocked this surface off here with a board sander to get it flat, and I took a little piece of sandpaper and just went around in here and kind of cut the bottom up, pulled my tape off here. So you can see what I got. It's coming off pretty good. Tore a little right there. I'm just gonna trim this a little with an X-Acto knife. Little bondo on it, it's holding it. A little right here in the top. The tape is holding my line. Looks really good, actually. A lot better than it was. And now I can take a little piece of sandpaper and just clean up that bottom. Mostly right where that tape was. Did leave a little bit of a rough spot. And doing a little final adjustment on that corner. That looks pretty good. It's parallel. Blow it out. Put a little primer on it, and that'll show us any errors that I still have. But basically, this little tape right there. Here. That's real straight. Primer will show it. I'll squirt some on and we'll have another look at it.